Hello everybody and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to create a countdown effect using animation nodes. Animation nodes is an add-on where you can install in Blender and it allows you to create so many really cool animations. To actually download the add-on, it is a little bit more tricky than you might think. You need to go to this page right here and click on this green download button. There is also a GitHub page where you can download the add-on. But doing it this way does not work for me. The only way I got animation nodes to work is to use this green button right there. So go ahead and click on this button. The link is down in the description. And if you're running on Linux or Mac, you can go ahead and select those over on the left side. Once you have downloaded that zip folder, you can go over to Edit, down to Preferences, and then underneath Add-ons, you can hit Install, and then navigate to where that zip folder is and install it. Then you should see an animation nodes right here. If you search in animation, go ahead and check that box and click on Save User Preferences. Now that we have animation nodes installed in Blender, we can get on with the tutorial. So we need to add in our text to actually have the countdown. So let's go ahead and delete the default cube, press Shift A and add in some text. I'm going to rotate this text 90 degrees along the X axis so it's sitting upright just like that. Now, if we split the view, we can go over to the Animation Nodes tab. If we go over to this menu here, you will see a Animation Nodes button. Go ahead and select that and give it a new node tree up on the top. Now, you won't see anything at the moment, and that is because we need to add in the Animation Nodes to actually change our text. Now, I'm going to be going through these nodes pretty slowly so you really understand what these nodes do and how they change the text. So the first node that we need to add is a time info node. So to do that, you can press Shift A and you will see a lot of different menus. Go over to animation and then time info right here. What this node allows you to do is take the frame number down in the timeline and plug that into whatever you want. So the next node that we need to add is a animate float node. This will allow us to change the duration of how long we want the countdown to be. So I'm gonna press Shift A, go over to animation and then animate float. Put that right here. Then you would take the frame and plug that into the time of the animate float option. And we see a couple of values here that we can play around with. We'll go through those in just a second. We need to add in another node. I'm gonna press Shift A, go over to number, and then down to float to text. This will allow us to change how many decimals or how many numbers will be in our countdown. And this is important. You need to take the result, not the time, the result, and plug that into the number. And the last node that we need to add is an object node that will enable us to select this text. So the animation nodes actually changes this object. So you can press Control A to search and type in the word text object, and you should see text object output. Go ahead and select that and place it here. Then take the text, plug that into the text, and then of course select the text in the drop-down menu. You also need to click this little button on the side to enable it to change it. And there we go, we now have numbers for our text. Now let's go ahead and go through these options and you can really customize this how you want. So over here on the animate float option, we have the start and the end. Currently it's set to 0, and if we play it, nothing really happens. We need to set the end frame to a value of 10. And then for the duration, this is how long the countdown will last. So currently it's set to 20. So if I play our simulation, it's only gonna last for 20 frames. If I want this to last for 10 seconds, and we're running at 24 frames a second. And to check your frame rate, you can go over to the output section here, and the frame rate is currently set to 24. So the duration would be 240 for a 10 second animation. If we restart and play this, it'll last for 10 seconds as you can see here, and it's counting up. If I want this to count down, I can go ahead and change these values. So the start will be 10 and the end frame will be 0. So we'll start at 10 seconds and end at 0. Now, if we play this, you will see this is what it looks like. Pretty cool. Over in the float to text node, this allows us to change how many numbers will be in our countdown. Right here, we have 3 decimals, so you can see there's 1, 2, 3 decimals just like that. If we bring this down to 2, it will only have 2 decimals. The minimum length controls how many numbers will be in your countdown. Currently, it's set to 10, but there's only actually 9. And I'm gonna set this to a value of 5. So we have just 4 numbers for our countdown, and that looks pretty cool. Now let's say you wanted a delay from where this countdown starts. Let's say you wanted it to start at frame 30 rather than at 1. You can do this easily by adding in a delay node. So if I press Shift A, go over to animation and delay, I can place that right here. Then the delay controls how long the delay will be. If I set this to a value of 30, it will start at frame 30 rather than at 1. So now if we watch the timeline, once it hits 30, it'll start the countdown. So you can really customize this however you want, and the cool thing about using animation nodes is you can customize the text as well. So if I go over to the text panel right here, I can go underneath geometry, change this extrude value up a little bit, and now we have some 3D text. And this works exactly how it's supposed to. We restart the animation, it reaches 30, and it starts to count down. You can also change the font in real time as well. So if I open up the font tab, I can just select a random font. And here we can see the font is working as well. Once it reaches frame 30, it'll start to count down. So using this method gives you a lot of control and you can create some really awesome results. So let's go through these nodes one more time so you really understand what they're doing. Here is the time info node, which is taking the frame. It's plugging that into a delay, so it's delaying this animate float until it reaches the value that you set in the delay, which is 30. From there, it goes into the animate float, which has a start of 10, so it's starting the text at 10 seconds, or at a value of 10, and ending at a value of 0 with the duration of 240. From there, it's plugging into a float to text, which allows us to change how many numbers are in our countdown. With a value of 5, it's actually displaying 4 numbers, and then we have the 2 decimals right here, we can see the decimal, and then 7, 9, which is 2. From there, it plugs into the text output, which enables us to select the text that we want to change. If I press Shift D and drag this upwards, and we restart the animation and play it, you can see this stays where it's at. But if I was to select that new text that we just added, it'll change this one. So now if we restart and play it, this one stays where it's at, but this one is now moving. You can also have multiple countdowns. So if I select all of these objects, hit Shift D, drag this lower, I can select that bottom text by selecting text, and then I can change the values how I want. So let's say I wanted this to be 20 seconds rather than just 10. We restart and play this, we can have two timelines just like that. So there you go guys, that is how you create a countdown using animation nodes. Animation nodes are super cool and you can create so many cool animations using them. And I'm planning on creating lots of tutorials, so make sure you click that subscribe button to stay notified whenever I upload a new Blender tutorial. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a like and comment down below what you would like to see next.